Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I have another project I want to share with you, and this one has been, I've been working on this for, I don't know, like 3 weeks off and on, and I just couldn't get it finished, and I finally just finished it yesterday. So, I thought I would share it with you. This is made from those, wallpaper pieces that I have. And, this one was kind of a textured one. See the texture there? And, I have paint on my hands, so pardon my fingers. Just decoupaged some ephemera that I had, and this is like an old, like advertisement or something. And then I found this image in my images, and I printed her on just some regular printer paper. And I think she's gorgeous. She kind of doesn't have an identity, and she's turning, you know, with her back, but at the same time she's looking intently. To me, anyway, she's looking intently at something, and or deep in thought. So, I thought, why not just make like a dream state as a background for her? And so this is what I came up with. I used the molding paste, and I also used, you can see all the little dots here. Those are the perfect pearls, and I also put that inside the butterflies. I use the, let me see if I can get this to focus. I use the crackle. There you go. The crackle molding paste. And then you can see the perfect pearls. Or it's not perfect pearls. It's this, pearl pen by Viva. That I used, but it's like perfect pearls. And then I just added, I love working with doodads and little tiny intricate pieces. You know, I'm always doing some sort of little intricate collages. So I use the Martha Stewart butterflies and just some beads and some bling and some resin. And this is some leftover pearls, say it in pearls, that I had a little tiny bit from Prima. And then these are just those mesh bling. Little flower, silk flower there, and paper flowers. I put some of the perfect pearls in the middle of the of the butterfly, and there's a button with the bling on top, and more beads. Some resin pieces. More little blingy berry type of bling. And this is a marble that I've had on my desk for probably 3 years, waiting for something to put it on. So I put it on this one. I thought green, throw some green in there. So I tried to just put all different colors. These are some of the my images, my butterfly images. I just glittered up. And with flowers from my wifey Julie. More little gorgeous resin pieces. Bling and more butterflies and more beads. Those butterflies were cut out of some scrap paper, the glitter scrap paper. This is an acetate butterfly that I stickled up. And yeah, so it was really simple to do. All I did was just arrange all the little bits. There we go. And used the stencil. That is it. Is my little project. It took me forever to finish. And yeah, I think she came out really pretty. I put pearls on her neck and my hair. That just came out cool, and it shouldn't have taken me 3 weeks to do, but I haven't been in my room, so that's why it took so long. And it's really dimensional. That's what I love about it. It's very, very dimensional. And I'll probably put it in a either back it on a canvas or put it in a one of those boxes, those photo boxes. But yep, that's my little project that I wanted to share. I have more coming up soon. Lots of art journal pages that I have not uploaded yet, and a couple more projects that I'm gonna try to finish. So stay tuned. I'm gonna have my junk journal and my junk journal kit, and yeah, more videos. I'm slowly getting back into coming in my craft room and getting stuff done. So, yeah. Bye, everyone. Thank you to my new subbies. Thank you, everyone, for watching, and God bless. Bye.